Hello, this is Elijah Henderson from Cryptid Studies Institute, bringing you a new series of videos that we like to call Time Lost Tales. This video series is devoted to supposedly and alleged to be true stories and tales that have become almost lost to history and are largely unknown entirely. Today we will remove the veil of time on multiple stories that perhaps you haven't ever had a chance to be familiar with. And these stories range from new to old in a somewhat simple manner where we can upload them fairly quickly and give you fresh, interesting content. And today, I'll be bringing you one woman's encounter with the unknown that surely changed her outlook on the woods forever. This is The Whistle. Long ago, on a farm in South Carolina, a woman lived quietly alone with her dog, a small terrier dog to be specific. The day began to wane, slowly giving way to the darkness of night, and unbeknownst to the woman, tonight, her farm would become a site of great terror, lasting for the rest of the time that she would occupy that strip of land. Because as the hours of night continued to pass, she began to hear a whistling sound emanating somewhere in the hills beyond her property. She couldn't identify exactly what it was. It was definitely a whistle, but it didn't sound exactly human in origin. In fact, it didn't sound like anything in nature that she was familiar with. Whatever it was, it didn't seem strictly kosher to her, and her dog agreed as it began to bark and whine at the alien sound. Her dog listened intensely while it stood guard atop her enclosed backyard porch. The especially unusual detail about this whistle was the fact that it seemed almost untraceable. It was almost impossible to determine where it was coming from. However, as best as she could tell, it was coming from out of the hills and toward her home. The woman had currently been attending chores around the house when the strange noises began to emanate in the distance. She ceased her chores and took a moment to better listen to the odd disturbance, which gradually began to upset the little terrier greater and greater. Slowly, the sounds progressed, and it became louder and louder, and the enigmatic whistle gradually grew closer, meaning that whatever it was making the sounds was currently on the move. She figured that perhaps it was the local children playing some sort of prank to scare her, but still, as a precaution, she gathered her late husband's revolver and bolted the front door shut. Any unwelcome guest would surely be frightened away by the sounds of her dog barking. Eventually, the whistle slipped closer and closer to the house from out of the darkness. And though the sounds drew nearer, she couldn't see anything out in the blackness of night. Then suddenly the whistles began to approach closer, then suddenly and intelligently turn and round the corner of the house. By this time, the woman had to have been frightened terribly, and her heart must have been beating like a drum, as the mysterious sounds now began to approach her back porch, where the small terrier was now in a horrible frenzy, barking and whining at the thing that was making its way closer. Then all of a sudden, the dog made a terrible outcry, and the whistle stopped as the unknown invader had reached the porch. Now it was forever beyond any possible safety of the farmhouse. The woman listened in horror to the awful sounds of struggle on her back porch, and then silence. Nothing lasted but the woman and the stillness of the night as she stood alone, trembling with fear. I can almost imagine that silence, too, as almost deafening and overpowering in itself as she listened intently for anything to make a sound. But it didn't. No more sounds were to come from beyond the door that separated it and her. She avoided going outside, and somehow she managed to fall asleep, never daring to peer outside the window, perhaps avoiding the risk of seeing some horrible thing that would forever be etched into her mind. Gradually, the light of morning began to break over the tops of the hills that on the night before had housed some terrible and frightening entity. Now that morning had finally come, and whatever it was from the night before seemed to have vanished, she cautiously opened the door and stepped outside, only to find a puddle of blood pooling in the spot that her dog had resided only hours ago. What sort of horrible creature or thing attacked her dog, and what carried its body away beyond the farmhouse? The woman never found out, and she never seen her dog again. No one will ever know for sure what horrible aberration came and attacked on that dark and lonely night in South Carolina. What do you think it was? Was it a Sasquatch, since they are commonly known to make strange whistles and chirps, and even sometimes act hostile toward dogs? Was it something of a supernatural nature that came and spirited away the dog into nothingness? Or was it something else entirely? We can only speculate now after all these years, but personally, in our humble opinion, we believe it to be a somewhat apoplectic Bigfoot that whisked the terrified terrier away on that night in South Carolina. So, friends, if on some night you yourself begin to hear the same strange and unsettling whistles begin to approach slowly from out of the hills and the hollers where you reside, use caution, shut and lock your doors, and bring your beloved pet into the safety of your homes, because you never know what it is that's making that unusual whistling in the nighttime hour.